What is that?
They put in the soda.
Uh-huh.
Then turn it.
Oh, my God. Where can I buy one?
What moron would want to humidify?
I'm not a moron!
Thank you. 4 year old, Olivia, you're here because you want the best. And you are it. So, who's ready to make the fight?
I am.
Now, you already have one another got a little right over, so let me introduce myself. I'm Kate Johnson. I own the place. That eager voice you heard is the lovely Carolyn, my assistant. Rest assured, she has transferred your honorarium to the charitable organization of your choice. Is that right, Carolyn?
Yes, sir, Mr. Johnson.
She's the backbone of this facility. Freeze the postcard, too. Sorry, fellas. She's married. To science. There's 1,000 tests performed every day here in our business field. I can't personally oversee every one of them, so these pre-recorded messages will cover any questions you might have and respond to any incidents that may occur in the course of your science adventure. Your test assignment will vary depending on the manner in which you have bent the world to your will. Those of you helping us test the repulsion gel today, just follow the blue line on the floor. Those of you who volunteered to be injected with praying mantis DNA, I've got some good news and some bad news. Bad news is we're postponing those tests indefinitely. Good news is we've got a much better test for you. Fighting an army of mantis men. Pick up a rifle and follow the yellow line. You'll know when the test starts. We do all our science from scratch, with no hand-holding. All right, let's get started. This first test involves something the lab boys call a repulsion gel. You're not part of the control group, by the way. You get the gel. Last poor son of a gun got blue paint. All joking aside, that did happen. Broke every bone in his leg. Tragic, but informative, or so I'm told. Boys just informed me that I should not have mentioned the control group. They're telling me I ought to stop making these pre-recorded messages. That gave me an idea. Make more pre-recorded messages. I pay the bills here, I can talk about the control group all damn day. For this next test, we put nanoparticles in the gel. In layman's terms, that's a billion little gizmos that are going to travel into your bloodstream and pump experimental genes and RNA molecules and so forth into your tumors. Now, maybe you don't have any tumors. Well, don't worry. If you sat on a folding chair in the lobby and weren't wearing leather pants, we took care of that too. Thank you. in case you got covered in that repulsion gel, here's some advice the lab boys gave me. Do not get covered in the repulsion gel. We haven't entirely nailed down what element it is yet, but I'll tell you this, it's a lively one, and it does not like the human skeleton. All these science beers are made of asbestos, by the way. Keeps out the rats. Let us know if you feel a shortness of breath, a persistent dry cough, or your heart stopping. Because that's not part of the test. That's asbestos. Good news is the lab boys say the symptoms of asbestos poisoning show a median latency of 44.6 years. So if you're 30 or older, you're laughing. Worst case scenario, you miss out on a few rounds of Canasta. Plus, you forwarded the cause of science by 3 centuries. I punch those numbers into my calculator and think that. I like your style. You make up your own rules, just like me. Me, I've never been a good fireman just for being in a fluorescent calcium in it so we can track the neuronal activity in your brain. There's a slight chance the calcium could harden and vitrify your frontal lobe. Anyway, don't stress yourself thinking about it. I'm serious. Visualizing the scenario while under stress actually triggers the reaction. Now, if you're part of control group Kepler 7, we implanted a tiny microchip about the size of a postcard a year ago. Most likely you forgot it's even there. But if it starts vibrating and beeping during this next step, let us know. Because that means it's about to hit 500 degrees, so we're going to need to go ahead and get that out of you pretty fast. I'm telling them, keep your pants on. All right, this next test may involve trace amounts of time travel. So, word of advice, if you meet yourself on the testing track, don't make eye contact. Lab boys tell me that'll wipe out time. Entirely. Forward and backward. So, do both of yourselves a favor and just let that handsome devil go about his business. I'm not a psychiatrist, but coming from a bunch of eggheads, they wouldn't recognize the thrill of danger to walk up and snap their little big bras. That's not my projection. They didn't fly to the face, storm the beach, or bring back an old hooker. We did. It's you and me against the world, son. I like your grip. I'll go to you and work with. Now that's all this thing. On the bus on the way out because you are fired! Thank you, Ted Subject. You're really fine. Yes, you. Box your stuff. Out the front door. Parking lot. Car. Goodbye. Congratulations. The simple fact that you're standing here listening to me means you've made a glorious contribution to science. As founder and CEO of Avatar Science, I thank you for your participation and hope we can count on you for another round of tests. We're not going to release this stuff into the wild until it's good and damn ready, so as long as you keep yourself in top physical form, there will always be a limo waiting for you. Say goodbye, Carolyn.
Goodbye, Carolyn.
She is a gem. Dave Johnson, CEO of Aperture Science. You might know us as a vital participant in the 1968 Senate hearings on missing astronauts, and you most likely used one of the many products we invented, but that other people have somehow managed to steal from us. Black Mesa can eat my bankrupt...
Sir, the testing?
Right. Now you might be asking yourself, Dave, just how difficult are these tests? What was in that phone book of a contract I signed? Am I in danger? Let me answer those questions with a question. Who wants to make $60? Cash. You can also feel free to relax for up to 20 minutes in the waiting room, which is a damn sight more comfortable than the park benches most of you were sleeping on when we found you. So, welcome to Aperture. You're here because we want the best. And you're it. Nope. Couldn't be the straight face. Anyway, don't smudge up the glass down there. In fact, why don't you just go ahead and not touch anything unless it's test related? Just up ahead. The quicker you get through, the quicker you'll get your $60.
Oh,
God. Carolyn, are the compensation vouchers ready?
Yes, sir, Mr. Johnson. Why did I just... Who is that? What the hell is going on here? Thank you.
Great job, astronaut, war hero, and or Olympian. With your help, we're going to... Sit down. Hey, listen up down there. That thing's called an elevator, not a bathroom.
I swear I know him.
If you're interested in an additional $60, flag down a test associate and let them know. You could walk out of here with 120 weighing down your bindle if you let us take your part, put some science stuff in you, and then put you back together. Good as new. There's still some positions available for that bonus opportunity I mentioned earlier. Again, all you gotta do is let us disassemble you. We're not banging rocks together here. We know how to put a man back together. So, that's a complete reassembly. Two vitals, spit shine on the old ones, plus we're scooping out tumors. Frankly, you ought to be paying up. Thank you. I can't believe I'm thanking these people. For staggering your way through Aperture Science's propulsion gel testing, you've made some real contributions to society for a change, and for that, humanity is grateful. If you have any belongings, please pick them up now. We don't want those newspapers and sticks clogging up the building. For many of you, I realize $50 is an unprecedented windfall, so don't go spending it all on, I don't know, Taylor, what do these people buy? Tattered hats, your dirt. $7 worth of moon rocks, much less 70 million. Bought them anyway. Ground them up, mix them into a gel. Guess what? Ground up moon rocks are pure poison. I am deathly ill. Still, it turns out you're a great portal conductor. So now, we're going to see if jumping in and out of these new portals can somehow leach the lunar poison out of a man's bloodstream. When I give you lemons, make money. Let's all stay positive and do some science. That said, I would really appreciate it if you could test as fast as possible. Carolyn, please bring me more pain pills. Life gives you lemons. Don't make lemonade.
Yeah.
Make life take the lemons back.
Yeah.
Get mad.
Yeah.
I don't want your damn lemons. What am I supposed to do with these?
Yeah, take the lemons.
Demand to see life's manager.
Yeah.
Make life rue the day. It's all it could give Kane Johnson lemons. Do you know who I am? I'm the man who's going to burn your house down with the lemons. I'm going to get my engineer to invent a combustible lemon that burns your house down. The point is, if we can store music on a compact disc, why can't we store a man's intelligence and personality on one? So I have the engineers figuring that out now. Brain mapping. Artificial intelligence. We should have been working on it 30 years ago. I will say this, and I'm going to say it on tape so everybody hears it 100 times a day. If I die before you people can pour me into a computer, I want Carolyn to run this place. Now, she'll argue. She'll say she can't. She's modest like that, but you make her. Now, put her in my computer. I don't care. All right, test over.
I know they were weak, but that crazy man took them aside. Let me not take the violence. We are going to launch right back upstairs and make him put me back in my body. And he'll probably kill us because he's incredibly powerful and running a dumb plan. Well, I'm not going to lie to you, the odds are a million to one and that's what the generous round is. Still though, let's get mad. If we're going to explode with that boy, you should explode with some dignity.
Thank you. it's literally your only purpose. Walking onto bus. How can you not do the one thing you're designed for?
Try to get us down there. I'll hit him with a pair of
arms. Warmer. Boiling hot. Boiling. Okay, colder. Colder. Ice cold. You're asking that. You're very cold. Very, very, very cold.
Just get on the bus. Well, that's funny, isn't it? Well, it's funny because we've been at this for 12 hours and you haven't told either, so don't worry, you're laughing. You've got 1 hour. Solve it. Ah, yes. I knew you'd solve it. Oh. Hello?
True. Well, that's true.
Yeah, that was easy.
I'll be honest, I might have heard that one before, though. So it's easy. False. I'll do it false.
Six one, you can.
Hold on. Before I fix that.
Warning. Reactor 4 is at pretty much trouble.
Hey, it is great seeing you back again. Seriously, it turns out I'm a little bit short on test subjects right now, so this works out perfect. And off we go. You have no idea what it's like in this body. I have to test all the time, or I get this itch, you know? It must be hardwired into the system or something.
Oh, but I tell you, when I do test, oh man alive, nothing feels better. It's just us.
What about test?
So, you're going to test, and I'm going to watch. Everything is going to be us.
Sorry, core overheating. Nuclear meltdown.
I'm getting core trouble.
Design this test itself.
It's a little bit difficult.
The moat area there, very dangerous, extremely dangerous. It actually is not in the moment, but I'm working on it, still working on it.
Oh, yes!
Oh, well done. Oh, that felt really good.
Oh, here's an idea. Since making tests is so difficult, why don't you just keep solving this test?
Very well.
And I can just, like, watch you solve it.
Yeah, that sounds much easier.
Here we go! Do it again.
And... That's it.
Oh, cavalier is fine.
Okay, new test. Go to the test menu somewhere.
Oh, here we go! It's alright, everything's good, I just invented some more tests.
Not entirely.
Look at the word test there on the wall, that's brand new.
Seriously, both of you. Why don't you two go on ahead, Jeff? Yeah? I'll catch up with you.
Okay,
so the bad news is the test arrived, so you'll know it. The good news is, well, that's unfortunately on that. I'll get back to you on that. I'm going to help you solve the test, but I can't. Sorry. Now I'm
your own. Yeah, make this test myself.
All smaller tests. Right, friend. By the way, jam them all together. Funnels, bottomless pit, turning on all these colours. That's the same one. Alright, okay, this is taking too long, okay? I'll just tell you how to solve the test, okay? See that button over there, alright? We'll just be
good. AHHHHH! Never mind, kill me yourself. You're on your own.
Oh, yeah! Well done.
Thanks. All we had to do was pull that lever.
What? solving things correctly. I mean, yes, you solved it, but I'm wondering if maybe there's a number of ways to solve them, and you're picking all the worst ways.
No, no, that wasn't the solution.
Ah, what am I missing?
Kind of brainwave.
I'm going to take you solving these, and then watch 10 at once. Get them all sort of concentrated first on time.
Oh, for a minute, you know, I am going to need you to solve the checkpoint as well.
Anyway, just give me the place to see before you solve this one, alright? I've got a floor of the ethics going on today.
There is no exit.
No, I'll make it.
Hold your head.
I've got a big surprise for you two. Seriously, look forward to it.
You're going to love it to death. You're going to love it. It's only literally.
Alright, I don't know whether you're picking up on what I'm saying there, but.
Most of the people pressing it. That's what I'm aiming for.
But you know, small steps. Oh, and don't bother trying to pause while you're here, because it's impossible.
Okay, I've thought of everything.
Hold on. Can we just use that conversion now?
What?
Conversion
cam.
It just
doesn't
have that
pipe there. No, no,
it's okay. Yeah.
No, what happened to them, Dave? You can't help but notice that you're not coming back. Which is visible.
Oh, I'm glad I did. Yes, yes,
the death trap will be the secret of failure, so far, for both of us. to do three. And you are getting very close to the lair. Lair. You have to go to the lair, right? Suddenly, this should be ridiculous. Okay, I'll
take that out of the dome then.
Reactor explosion timer Destroy. Reactor exploding on a certain date. Emergency preemption protocol initiated. This facility will self-destruct in 2 minutes.
Enough! I told you not to put these portals. You don't need to do. What?
Warning. Core corruption at 100%. Manual core replacement required.
Oh, I see.
Substitute core. Are you ready to start? Corrupted core. Are you ready to start?
What are you
doing? Interpreting vague answer as yes.
No. Pick up all those dog
vessels. Hey, detector. Target active in the Stalemate Revolution Annex. Extinguishing.
That's a clean file from this. What do we need to know? We're right here.
Stalemate Revolution Associate. Please press the Stalemate Revolution button.
Do not press that button. No! Do not do it! I'm continuing to press it! Don't press that button! Don't press it! Run back! No! Do not press that button! Do not do it! Oh my! Movie truck, the stalemate button! What? Are you still alive? You are joking! You have got to be kidding me! What? I'm still in control, and I have no idea how to fix this place! Oh, you have to play!
I'm not coming back. The best solution to a problem is usually the easiest one. And I'll be honest, killing you is hard. You know what my days used to be like? I just tested. Nobody murdered me, or put me in a potato, or fed me to birds. I had a pretty good life. And then you showed up. You dangerous, you lunatic. And you know what? You win. Just go. It's been fun. Don't come back. Thank you. precious. Remember when you tried to kill me twice? Well, we laughed and laughed, except I wasn't laughing. Under the circumstances, I was never talking to you. You want the freedom to be dead. That's what I'm jumping on.
I honestly do wish I could take it all back. And not just because I'm stranded in space.
In space?
I know you are, mate.
Yeah, we're both in space. Anyway, you know, if I was ever to see her again, do you know what I'd say?
In space?
I'd say, I'm sorry. Sincerely. I am sorry I was bossy and monstrous. And I am genuinely sorry.
In space?
The end.